Congratulations on this week. You've now got the top-selling CD in all of Quebec. Okay. Yeah.
Yes, thank you.
We went into the Archambault in Sherbrooke, and there it is, number one.
Yes, yeah. I know. I just had that news today, actually.
That's terrific.
Yes, I'm so proud, so happy, because the last album was released 4 years ago.
Right.
And this is totally a new approach, I'd say, a new approach. But it's funny to say that because this is the real first album, just voice and cello, because I sing and play cello. But those songs are covers. It's
right.
songs that were already existing.
Sure.
And I've been composing my own music for 12 years. Mm-hmm. So it's a little bizarre to give, you know, what I have the most intimate with my music, my voice and my cello, to give that for the first time to other songs
right.
than mine. So the rules I decided to follow, first of all, the lyrics had to be really like moving, touching.
Right.
And then the melody was important, just to let my voice fly. Because I always put the voice not behind the cello, but I say side by side, the same levels. But now it's really the role of being an interpret that was the first thing on this album. It was not the composer, it was the musician.
So we move now.
One of the things I find very fascinating about your music is you take themes into new areas. You have a thematic or concept approach to your albums. I would say, is the word avant-garde correct in describing?
Yes. I think I can handle that.
Now, how has your music evolved? I mean, you started in 1999, yes. The first CD. Okay,
yes.
How has...
Oh, my God, yeah.
I mean, it's been a good development, huh? Mm-hmm. When we saw you in Sherbrooke, you had an audience of all ages.
Yes,
young girls, yeah. Young boys, elderly people. Have you found that your audience continues to expand as you go into new avenues?
Yes, I think so. And I've been, people put me in such a weird
category.
Right. But actually, I don't really know why. Because if you just go into the artist I am or in the music I'm doing, it's not so bizarre.
Right.
It's just because it's voice and cello and we're not used to hear that. It's my first goal, it's to make something emotional, something beautiful.
Right.
You know, it's not to be so special. This is just what I am, but this is not the goal. The goal is just to put the emotion and music up front. Album, it's always for every artist. I think it's a different race. You know, it's different because it's the first one. You never know. Maybe it might be the last one too.
Right.
you never know. So you put everything you want, everything you are. You know, it's the first one. You're maybe 20, 25, 30. You don't. So you have with you from all those years. End up to be in this first album. This is a really important moment, actually. I think now I'm in this new way just to apprivoiser, to experiment the power of words.
Right.
Yes, because instrumental, I had the chance to just place the music at first. You know, there were no words, but a lot of voice. And music is such a powerful language. So I had this chance to just place it in my fingers, in my voice, just to talk with that. And now, okay, I'm going to add words.
You have the Vanessa Paradis song,
yes.
Which everybody remembers from like the almost the disco era.
Yes.
It's a whole different sound.
And I was such a kid when that song was on the radio. Sorry.
It's okay.
Like maybe a year ago, I was like, I just discovered the drama part of that, of the lyrics, the story. And the story was, I wasn't aware of that story when I was a kid. And I just discovered, wow, it's just a beautiful song.
Marilyn, pince sa bouche. Elle pense à John, rien qu'à John. Un sourire, puis un soupir. Entre deux, trois.
Linguistically, to my ears, French sounds so beautiful, okay? How different is it to interpret English and French in music?
Yeah, it's a very interesting question because there is such a big difference between the songs in English, the songs with no words, and the songs in French. Mm-hmm. I think we can't help it when we sing in our first language, for you would be in English, and now for me in French, it is so personal.
Right.
The voice has a very different sound if you sing in your own first language. I started cello in a classical school, but I started a cello quite late. I started piano when I was really young, and then guitar, and then cello. So music was part of my life since I was 4. But then cello arrived, I was maybe 18, 19.
Really?
Yeah. But, you know, I had such a background. I practiced like 8 hours a day. I was like really motivated. But as soon as I started cello, I started to sing with this instrument. So it grew together. And I was singing, playing guitar. So this part of rhythm cello is quite the same for me.
Tonight we're going to see a ukulele?
Yeah, a little bit.
And a harp?
Yeah.
Are those new additions or have you been playing those for a long time?
I've been playing those for a long time, but only in my living room.
Right.
Yeah, not for the audience. Ukulele is a little more natural. Harp, it's different. But strings, as soon as there is strings, I'm so inspired. I think I vibrate with the strings. If you give me a trumpet, I cannot do anything with that. Honestly, it's I love to hear it though, but I cannot play. I cannot. It's not the same. But strings.
Thank you. I fought hard so I couldn't plow. Overcome the silence that drove us apart.
I started this new tour solo. Yeah,
is this your first solo?
It's my first solo tour. I think my team have been waiting for that for so long. I was not ready for that, and I think with the songs too, there is something with that because those songs are already some people with me on stage because they have been composed by other people. So actually, there is something with that, and. Yes, I love to add arrangements, to have, we have so many good musicians around, and the album, just before this one, I almost did this kind of approach, but I, you know, at the last minute I was, oh, I would dream to have that musician playing this and that, so I think, of course, you're alone on stage. If you make a mistake, it's going to be big like that, right, for sure. But this is part of life, too. Cannot be perfect in the technical part of it.
Right.
But I think if you focus on the right emotion and the right reason why you're doing that, then there is no mistake.
Yeah.
Thank you.